Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We say, the name of Jesus, mountains tremble. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Tithe and our offerings. great appreciation and expectation for all the blessings that you have promised us when retired. In Jesus' name, we now receive by faith the hundredfold return on the seed that is now in our hands. We do this in obedience to your word. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen.
You ever seen that? Christ, the Christ paid for us, O God. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. Were it not for the blood of Jesus, we'd still be people dead for eternity, dead in sin, O God. No future, no hope, O God. But because of Jesus, O God, we have a living hope and a glorious future which awaits us, O God. Thank you, Lord, for the resurrection of Jesus Christ, your Son. We know, O Lord God, that he has risen from the dead and is ascended on high. O Lord God, far above all principality and power. And unto Jesus Christ and Jesus alone be your praise, glory, honor, and worship. We acknowledge Jesus Christ, your Son, as being supreme head of the church, which is his body, O God. The fullness of him dwelling in all, O God. We acknowledge the presence of the Holy Spirit this morning. Holy Spirit, we acknowledge your presence here in this place. Thank you that you teach us, lead us and you guide us in all truth. For you are indeed the Spirit of truth. We thank you, O Lord, O God, that it is through the agency of the Holy Spirit, O God, that we have a divine connection with you, O God. We thank you, Lord, O God, that we have the Word of God, O Lord. It's a more sure word of prophecy, Father God. O Lord, we thank you this morning for the power of your Word. We thank you for the authority of your Word. Father God, we thank you this morning, O Lord, for the saving grace, O Lord of God, this morning. We thank you, Lord, O God. Yes, O Lord, we thank you this morning for grace which saves, which heals, which delivers, which restores, O God. Thank you this morning, O Lord God, that with outstretched arm, you'll reach out to your people, O God. I pray, Lord, that faith will come to every man, every woman, every boy, every girl that is under the influence of my voice this morning, O God. I pray, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you will anoint, O Lord God, my vocal cords to declare your word to your people, O God. Lord, O God, we thank you, Lord, in spite of circumstances, in spite of what we see happening around us, in spite of what we hear, O God. We are not moved by what we see, what we feel, or what we hear, but we are moved by the word of God, O Lord. For it's by your word that faith comes, O Lord, and it is only faith that pleases you, O God. We thank you this morning, we give you praise, glory, and we give you honor. Lord, right here, and wash down my cousins, O God. Father, this is a celebration of all that you have done, Father God. Not just today, but for the rest of our lives, Father. We will celebrate the goodness of God. We will celebrate the grace of God. We will celebrate, O Lord God, the risen Christ of God. We thank you this morning. In Jesus' blessed name, O Lord. God, I yield myself, O Lord, to you. Bible says that everything that has breath,
hallelujah,
praise be in the Lord. Supernatural glory and grace for divine happenings. And I've shared, I think the month of January, I shared about the glory of God. We went in depth. We touched on various topics. Then I began to share with you over the past, I think about 2 or 3 weeks, about the Word of God. Amen. And this morning, I want to share with you, seeing that it is also a year of grace for divine happenings, it's important that we touch on the subject of you are divinely helped from above. I want you to remember that. I want you to embed that into your heart. That is the word, the title of my message this morning, is that you are divinely helped from above. That is something we should never forget. Amen. Because, you know, you must realize, many of you realize it by now. Some of you will realize it maybe later in your life. But what you have to realize, and every individual comes to this realization, is that the world is actually a battlefield. And because the world is a battlefield, we cannot do it on our own. We need divine assistance. You need divine intervention. You need divine help. No man can do it on his own. In the book of Psalms, if you'll go there with me, Psalms, the 121st chapter of Psalms, Psalm 121. Hallelujah. The psalmist writes here, he says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence comes my help?
Amen.
You see that he doesn't say, I will lift up my eyes to the government. I will lift up my eyes to the bank. I will lift up my eyes to my employer. He says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. Come on, somebody. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and the earth. Do you realize what that means? Is that the one who created the heavens and created the earth and everything that is in them is your helper. No man is going to help you. Say amen to that. He says, my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not, watch this, he will not allow your foot to be moved. In other words, if something comes your way and tries to set you off course, it needs his permission. Come and talk to me, somebody. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. While you're sleeping, listen, let me tell you, you know, many people, they rob themselves of God's gift of beautiful sleep. Because many people, you find, some people, they say, they can't sleep because they're worried about so many things. As long as you awake and trying to, worry is sin. Romans tells us very clearly that whatever is not of faith is sin. There's no worry in faith. Faith overrides worry. You see, so while you're laying on your bed and you're worried about tomorrow, you are actually playing God for your tomorrow. Because the Bible says he gives his beloved sleep. So if you've been robbed of your sleep, it means, remember John 10:10, the thief comes except to steal, kill, and destroy. So you're allowing the enemy to rob you of your precious sleep. Come on, talk to me. You speak, listen. The Bible tells us in 1 Peter, casting all your care upon him, for you know that he cares for you. Amen. That word cast, to cast your cares, it's. I don't know if any of you are fishermen or fisherwomen here, but if you go fishing and they say cast your, when you cast, it's what a force. It's what a force. Now understand this. God is your rock. He's your rock. And if you take your care and you cast it upon him, it means you're throwing it with a force. That thing, whatever you're throwing, that worry, that care, when you throw it to him, when you cast it to him, it shatters. Come on, talk to me. It shatters. If you take a glass and you just throw it like that, it will break. But if you throw it with a force, it will shatter in such a way you won't even be able to use super glue. But as long as you just take your problem and you must have audacious faith. Have strong faith. You tell that thing, in the name of Jesus. Come on, talk to me, somebody. God has made me the head and not the tail. I'm above you. I'm in authority over you. I take authority over, come on, talk to me. You must take authority over those thoughts. Thoughts of negativity, thoughts of doubt, thoughts of despair, thoughts of fear. You must take authority over that. And you, listen, tell your problem about your God. Because when you cast it through a force, it shatters. You can't fix it. But have you ever dropped a glass or a cup or a mug or whatever it is? It breaks. Sometimes you find it's your favorite. and then you're going to look for super glue or that ceramic glue or whatever glue you can get to try and put those pieces together. You see, and that is what you demonstrate when you cast your care unto God. And then you still take it from God and you say, oh God, I don't think you're doing a good enough job. I think I need to start thinking about this thing because you're taking your time. Understand, you've got to have faith. Understand that you are a child of God. You see, Daniel understood that when he prayed, God would answer. Yes, it may have taken 21 days for the angel to respond, but the angel said to Daniel, the very first day you prayed, I was sent. So you serve a God that's a prayer answering God. You must understand that you serve a prayer answering God. Some of you prayed prayers 5 years ago. I've got news for you. You may not have seen it coming to pass, but I'm telling you, it will come to pass. This is coming to pass. Come on, talk to me, somebody. The word of God is loaded with promises that came to pass. When you see, as you read the scriptures, it is God gave a promise. God gave a word. God, when God gives a word, it's an oath. It's a sovereign decree. And there's nothing the enemy can do about it. And you take it. You receive it by faith. You lay a claim on it. You grab a hold of it. It becomes yours. It's your property. It's your promise. And when you pray, you're praying in accordance with His word. And if you're praying in accordance with His word, you're praying in accordance with His will. And if you know that He hears you, you have the petitions of your hearts granted. So it's only a matter of time. Hallelujah. It's only a matter of time. Tell your neighbor, it's only a matter of time. Hallelujah. He says, He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. God doesn't get tired. He's not like us. He doesn't get tired. We get tired. That's why He gave us a beautiful gift of sleep, so that you can rest. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. It doesn't matter what's happening around you. It doesn't matter what's happening in the world. God has got you covered. God has got your back. Say amen to that. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. You see, there's a preservation for the child of God. God preserves you. You know, if you look at it this way, if I took vegetables from a garden and I put them on a table and I took some of those vegetables and I put preservatives and I put them into a can. You all know those you know, the canned vegetables you get, and I put them there. Which ones last longer? Which ones last longer? Come on, somebody. The ones that are outside the can, they dry up, they shrivel, they rot, they decay. The ones on the outside, but the ones that are in the can are preserved. They last longer. So God preserves you. Say that with me, I am preserved by Almighty God. That means what's happening in the world doesn't necessarily mean it's going to happen to you. Yes, we go through the same challenges, but understand this. There are those in the world that will not make it, but you will live to tell of the goodness of God. Amen. The Lord shall preserve you, not from some evil. He says all evil. All manner of evil. God will preserve you. Some of you so, you know, maybe you bitter. People said stuff about you, or people, you know, people laughed at you, gossiped about you. It doesn't matter. It's not your battle. You don't have to fight back. God preserves you. God will speak on your behalf. Yes, you may face a challenge at work. Someone will accuse you falsely. But don't give in to anger and, you know, all these things and you know, trying to take revenge. You just continue being good. God put you there to be good, to do good works. God put you there to be a light. A light only shines in the darkness. So you just continue to let your light shine, and you see how God does the rest for you. Your vindication is of God. Because you are preserved of God. Your preservation is of God. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall, watch it, the Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in. I like the Passion Translation. It says, when you leave your home, God will be with you. When you come back to your home, God will be with you. God is with you wherever you go. God is with you. Amen. You remember the word of God through his servant Moses. Blessed in your going out and blessed in your coming in. Hallelujah. God is with you. He preserves your going out. He preserves your coming in. From this, watch it, from this time forth and even forevermore. When God preserves you, brothers and sisters in Christ, it is not for a brief moment. It is not momentarily. It is a permanent, continuous state. God doesn't start something with you and just leave you in the middle. Abandoned you. No, he sees it through. Hallelujah. He sees it through. He who began this good work in you will continue doing it until the day of Christ Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Psalm 46 verse 1 tells us that God is an ever-present help in trouble. He's ever-present. This trouble may visit you. But don't let trouble trouble you. You trouble trouble. Oh, Jesus. Some will get it tomorrow. Understand, when trouble comes your way, you trouble trouble. How do you trouble trouble? You just keep on pressing into God. Come on, somebody. Because God is an ever-present helper in times of trouble. God is there. He's ever-present. You see, you... Maybe you at your workplace, or maybe you're traveling somewhere, or wherever you are, and you hear a bad report, you hear, you know, bad news. One thing you must never forget is that you have received the gospel of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The meaning of gospel is good news. That's why the Apostle Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation for everyone who believes. So when a bad report comes, you just remind yourself, whose report will you believe? I shall believe the report of the Lord. Glory to God, hallelujah. I don't care what the news said. I don't care what the government said. I don't care what the doctor said. I don't care what the lawyer said. I don't care what the employer said. I know what God said. God said it, that settles it. I'm going by what God has said. I'm going to hold fast to the word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. So when that, you know, when that news comes, understand that the Lord is an ever-present helper. That right there where you are, hearing that report, God is there. That's why you've got to commune with God and have fellowship with God. And when things like this happen, you can speak to Him. You can speak to Him. He's your Heavenly Father. He's your Abba. Abba is an Aramaic word of affection for a father. He's your Abba. Oh, Father. You know, when we were growing up as children, I remember, you know, when a child, as you walk to, you know, maybe you're going to town, wherever you're going, and your feet got sore, and you couldn't walk. And then you find the child will say, Mom or Dad, please Abba me. You remember that? You know what's Abba? They take you on the back. So you can come, you can call on him. You can call on him and he'll pick you up, he'll carry you through it. When you're tired, he'll be your strength. The times when you can't walk, he'll walk on your behalf. The times when you cannot, come on, talk to me, somebody. You cannot find the strength, he'll be your strength. Hallelujah. Amen. So here's the thing, when it seems that, you know, there's no way out, you must always remember that God will always arise for you. Amen. God arises for you. Hallelujah. You see, that's why I said in the beginning, we need divine help. Because without divine help, we will be, you know, we'll suffer defeat, we'll suffer shame, we'll suffer humiliation. Hallelujah. We all need help. If Daniel didn't receive help from above, those lions would have eaten him. If Israel did not receive help from above, the Egyptians would have slain them. If that widow at Zarephath didn't receive divine help from above, she and her son would have starved to death. We all need divine help. Amen. Praise God. So every man needs divine help, especially in the day and age that we are living in, brothers and sisters in Christ. We need God's help. Number one, we need help that defies all human solutions. There is no human solution that is permanent. There is no human solution that has a permanent state. It will always fail. Economies will fail. The plans of man will fail. Governments will fail. Institutions will fail. But God will never fail. The word of God will never fail. Talk to me, somebody. Say this with me. I serve a God who never fails. Amen. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Amen. We need, secondly, divine help that confounds the enemy and delivers miracles to us. See that? Confound. You know, the enemy will be looking at you and say, this one, I got them now. But then just when he thinks he has you, divine help comes and what happened? God happened. Divine assistance happened. Divine intervention happened. And you know, whenever there's divine help, whenever there's divine assistance, there's always a miracle. Because that's what a miracle is. Miracle is, listen, God lives in a realm called eternity. It is where the finger of God will just come into your present time zone and just touch something. Because when the finger of God moves, it suspends all natural laws. That's divine assistance. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, divine assistance. They went through that fiery furnace. They came out of there alive. The clothes were intact. They weren't even smelling of smoke. I believe that they were shining with glory because there was a fourth man in that furnace. And that fourth man, come and talk to me, somebody. He's the glory of God himself, so they were beholding the glory. When they came out, it was more glorious. Come and talk to me. I don't care what fire you're going through. I don't care what challenge you're going through. But I'm here to tell you this morning, you just hold on. Keep your eyes on Jesus, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. When you come and talk to me. You may be tried. Yes, you've been tried. But understand, with the trying, it's a time of testing. But when you come out as gold. You're going to be pure. You're going to be pure. Your faith is being strengthened. Hallelujah. God is our helper, beloved, and without God, we cannot do anything. Jesus himself said, without me, you can do nothing. You need God. We all need God. Talk to me, somebody. You have to come to the realization that without God, you are helpless. The help of man is vain. The Bible says it is vain to trust in princes. Amen. The Egyptians, speaking of the world, they shall help. Yes, they shall help. But it will all be in vain and it will be to no purpose. The help of flesh is futile. Come on, talk to me. You see, Joseph, you remember Joseph. How many of you remember Joseph? You remember Joseph. Joseph expected help from a man. You remember when Joseph gave the interpretations and the man said, don't worry, I'll remember you. I will speak on your behalf before Pharaoh. You see, Joseph was expecting help from that man. But you know what that man done? That man forgot. That man forgot about Joseph. But it was the help of God that caused Joseph to be remembered. You see, just when man has forgotten about you, God remembers you. Talk to me, somebody. You serve a God who remembers. Say amen to that. Amen. It was the help of God who eventually caused him to be remembered and caused him to be brought out of the prison and transferred into the palace. I want you to understand that help from above is far greater and better than help from abroad. You understand? Help from above is far greater and better than help from abroad. Because when you're seeking help from abroad, you're running into every corner. You're running around. You're running a rat race. But when you seek help from above, you're looking to one place only. Lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence comes my help. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Why tire yourself running to and fro over the earth, trying to look for help? You're not the one that's supposed to be running to and fro. You are the one that is supposed to be keeping your eyes on the Lord. Because the Bible says that the eyes of the Lord, watch it, the eyes of the Lord run to and fro over the whole earth to show himself strong on behalf of those whose heart is right with him. All you need to do is keep your heart right with God. God will come through for you. Talk to me, somebody. Amen. You know, sometimes we don't actually realize how strong our God is until we're faced with a strong battle. Sometimes you don't realize how strong God is until you're faced with a strong battle. Let us go to Judges, Judges chapter 15. The book of Judges 15. Let me just share something with you from the life of Samson. Judges 15 and verse number 14, the Bible says, when he came to Lehi, the Philistines came shouting at him. You see, the enemy came shouting at him. Then the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him, and the ropes that were on his arms became like flax that is burned with fire, and his bonds broke loose from his hands. He found a fresh jawbone of a donkey, reached out his hand, and took it and killed 1,000 men with it. Hallelujah. Amen. You see, the anointing became strongest on Samson when the Philistines shouted at him. You see, the anointing rested on Samson. The anointing was there. But when the enemy started shouting at him, shouting threats at him, all of a sudden, the anointing became stronger because he kept on pressing into God. When you press into God, that's where you receive your strength. when Samson's eyes were removed that he couldn't see, and they mocked him. All he did, he asked him, please, bring me to a pillar. Bring me to the main pillars of the temple. And then they put him there, because their strength, the strength of the Philistines, was in the pillars of their temple. So Samson knew that if I can get there, I've got a strength that is greater than this. And he just asked, he said, oh my God, oh Lord, if I found favor in your sight just this once, what happened? You find all of a sudden, what a great push, Samson pushed at those pillars and that entire temple came down. Samson slew more Philistines at his death than in his lifetime. One man, with a jawbone of a donkey, he slays 1,000, but at his death, he kills tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, because he pressed into God. When you understand how great your God is, you understand how great you are. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When you understand how strong, how powerful, how mighty your God is, you understand how strong you actually are. Because you know whose you are. You know who you belong to. You must remember this. Greater is he that is where? In me than he that is in the world. I'm not worried about the one in the world. I'm concerned about the one that is within me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. So you see, when you see, you know, sometimes, you know, I'm amazed at people. Something sounds nice, so they just buy it. They say, oh, it never rains but pours. You ever heard that? When someone's going through a challenge, oh, it never rains but pours. Hey, it rains blessings for a child of God. Amen. Don't be dismayed. Don't be discouraged. Don't be afraid when they're gathering against you. Doesn't matter when the enemy is gathering. Listen, the gathering, the enemy gathers just to be scattered. Hallelujah. The enemy may gather, but he gathers to be scattered. If you look at Isaiah 54 verse 15, the Bible tells us that surely they shall gather together, but whosoever shall gather against you shall fall for your sake. That's what God says. Hallelujah. The enemy's agenda is to gather, but God's own agenda is to scatter him. Amen. Hallelujah. You remember Deuteronomy 28 verse 7? Your enemy may come one way at you, but he'll scatter on 7 different ways. You must realize that God will arise for you. You must realize that divine help will always speak for you. You are divinely assisted. Can you say that with me? I am divinely assisted. I'm speaking to some of the young people. You know, people may tell you that there's no employment opportunities. The unemployment rate is, you know, it's just going, it's growing higher and higher, just getting higher, just increasing. They may tell you inflation is increasing, but I'm here to tell you as a child of God, you grow faster than inflation. Because listen, I know of a God who was with a widow. And for 3 years, her flour, her oil did not finish because she was divinely assisted. Yes, 10 rand to someone in the world may just do so much, but 10 rand to a child of God will do even more. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. You know, Pastor Sharon and I were talking the other day. We're talking about, listen, how we went through, you know, we went through great, you know, whatever you go through, we go through the same. The times when you've only got a little bit of rice and a little bit of sugar, and you've got one or two tomatoes and an onion, and you don't know what to do. But as we look back, we say, my God, God carried us with that. And I look at that and I look at when I wasn't saved and I wasn't serving the Lord, it's a big difference, because when I wasn't saved, I had to go and borrow all over and make debt. But when I became saved and I started serving God, how God came through, I didn't have to go make a loan. I didn't have to go make a debt, because God provides. He's Jehovah Jireh. The Lord my provider. Talk to me, somebody. You must understand that. A divine help will speak for you when you can't speak. Every tongue that rises against you in judgment, God will permanently silence for your sake. You don't need to speak. You don't need to prove a point. You have a God who speaks for you. You can listen, look unto Jesus. The best example for Christian living is not a man, but it is Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. Look at Jesus when they accused him. Look at Jesus when they brought him before the religious leaders of his day. They brought him before the king. And they made accusations. An innocent man. The Bible says he opened not his mouth. He didn't say a thing. What did Jesus say? Turn the other cheek. Turn the other cheek. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. See, Psalm 46 verse 2 tells us that though the land be carried into the sea, yet we will not fear. Yet we will not fear. Because we do not look at the situation. We look unto our God. This year, 2022, I want you to remember that. Do not look at situations. Look unto our God. Look unto God. God will come through for you. Many of you thought you wouldn't make it in 2020. You thought you wouldn't make it in 2021. But guess what? It's 2022. You're still around. That means God still has a plan with you. God still has a purpose with you. Hallelujah. There's nothing too hard for God to do. There's nothing too difficult for him. His arm is not short that he cannot save. God can save. Amen. And there's no situation that God cannot handle. I mean, remember, the psalmist says he's the creator of heaven and earth. You see, someone may tell you, but listen, you know, there's no opportunities for our children. Because we keep hearing that. And the enemy wants you to hear that. Because he wants to instill fear in you. He wants to instill doubt in you. He wants to instill disbelief in you. But you must recognize and realize that you serve a God who's a creator. If there's no opportunity, I have a God who will create one for me. Talk to me, somebody. It was by the help of God that the walls of Jericho came down. Yes. The Israelites had to encircle the city. They had to praise. There was a responsibility on their part. But understand that without divine assistance, those walls would never have come crumbling down. You see, when God came through and God intervened, the foundations of Jericho were destroyed. Not just the walls, but the foundations. That's why when God comes through for you, you must understand there are foundations that were destroyed, but that you are trying to rebuild in your life. Don't look back. Remember we sang that song, "You have rescued my life." You remember? And I'm never going back. I'm never looking back. Because Jesus says, once the hand is set to the plow, anyone who looks back is not fit for the kingdom. See, that's what the Israelites, that's the mistake the Israelites made when they were in the wilderness. They kept looking back to the garlic and the leeks of Egypt. Though God was feeding them with manna from heaven, God brought the quail from the sea right into their camp. They still kept looking back at the garlic and the leeks of Egypt. And What happened? They died in the wilderness and they never made it to Canaan. But praise God, not you say, not me. Amen. The 2 Chronicles chapter 26 verse 15, the Bible says that King Uzziah did exploits because he was marvelously helped by God until he was strong. King Uzziah, he did great exploits. He did great things for God because God didn't just help him. He was marvelously helped by God until he became strong. God will continue helping you. Till you become strong, you will be helped. Talk to me, somebody. He'll continue helping you until you receive your strength. Till you revive, till you receive your strength, God will continue helping you. Amen. Listen, what does the gospel say? Let the weak say, I am strong. God says, my grace is sufficient for you. My strength is made perfect in weakness. So don't focus on your weaknesses. God is your strength. Keep your focus on God. Because when your focus is on God, all the things that you consider to be your weaknesses cease to exist. Because now, all of a sudden, when you look to Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith, you get to a place where you understand, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens. It is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me. Amen. So with the help of God, you will make it in this life. Amen. I say with the help of God, you will make it in this life. When you don't know what to do, God will arise for you. Amen. Hallelujah. The help of God will cause you to win every battle of life. Every battle of life, you will win it. Amen? Because he assured us in Isaiah 41, from 10 to 14, God says that he will help us. He'll never leave us, nor will he forsake us. He's with you to the end. When it seems that you can't make it anymore, when it seems that you're without strength, when it seems that you like, you know, you like the nation of Israel. You're in a dry and a thirsty land. You can always run to the rock that is higher than you.
Amen.
The book of Psalms, hallelujah, hallelujah. Psalm 61 verse 2 says this, from the end of the earth will I cry unto you. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. See? When you are without strength, when you are thirsty, whatever it is that you need, run to God. The problem people make is instead of running to God, they run from God. Many people are doing that in life today. Ask them, why don't you come to church? Why are you not serving the Lord? I'm not ready. God never ever asked you to be ready. All God said is come as you are. He said come as you are. Because as you come, all those imperfections, he perfects. You understand? He perfects all that. Amen. It doesn't matter what the solution, what the situations or the troubles are around you. When God sends help to you, every storm becomes calm. There are five things I want you to remember. You can make a note of this in closing. Number one, how do you receive or access divine help? Divine help is access by prayer. Divine help is accessed by prayer. Number two, it is when we come to the throne of grace that we receive help to face our race. must come before the throne of God. Hebrews 4:16 says, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and receive an abundance of grace to help in our time of need. You see that you access divine help through prayer. And also, you must come to the throne of grace so that you can receive grace for your race. You with me? Point number three, to be prayerless is to be helpless. To be prayerless is to be helpless. Because when you pray, you are communing with God. God, listen, God is interested in every minute detail of your life. It doesn't matter how small. God is interested in that. There are certain things that you can tell men. Men will laugh at you and consider you actually, ah, this is a fool. But God will never do that. He's interested in that. Every minute detail. He wants to know about it. What are your dreams? You see, many people say, ah, God knows my dreams. Have you told him about them? Have you asked him for help concerning your dreams? To know your dreams, and to know your goals. Involve God in all of that in your life. Many times, you know, yes, the end of the month, we write our grocery lists, and, you know, and you sometimes many, you know, you write your budget. Hello? People write out their budgets. Your budget. Have you ever taken your budget to God? Have you ever done that? Lord, this is my budget. Come on, somebody. Amen. Number four, things will cease to work if you cease to pray. Things will cease to work. You know, prayer is fresh oil. It's like oil. What's that thing, Brother Rishi? It's a Q20? Q20, eh? You know what's Q20? What do you use it for? Sometimes you find you're going to try and loosen a bolt, but it's rusted. And for long, you know, you battle and you can't get it to turn, and then you go get some Q20 and you put it on it. All of a sudden, you see, sometimes problems that have been so fixed in your life, you can't see your way through, you can't get around it. That's when you just need some Q20, you need some prayer, put some prayer there. Pray the word, speak the word. Now you see, all of a sudden, things start to shift. Things start to move. Hallelujah. You see, so when you cease to pray, things cease to work. That's why you find someone who doesn't pray will always be complaining. Hallelujah. A prayerless person has a disease called monolitis. It's true. Because they're looking for human help. And human help, it's all in vain. And you find people disappointed. Now all of a sudden, they're complaining about the situation, they're complaining about this person that was supposed to help them, and complaining about that and that. They only complain. But if you ask the person, listen, please stop. Tell me, how often do you pray? They won't be able to answer. Many times they can't tell you when last they prayed. You see, that monolitis. I don't know about you, but at home, if there's a door that we ever open, open and I just hear a squeak, it's an irritation to me. Maybe you're different, I don't know, I can't stand it. Because you're trying to sleep, you're trying to concentrate, and someone knows, you know, they want to irritate you, so they just take the door. And you say to you say, where's the oil? Where's the Q20? And you just go and you can just silence it. And sometimes you've got three people in your life. So what do we need to do? Pray for them. Pray for them. When they come and they say, listen, let's pray. That's all you do, let's pray. Before they even start complaining, let's pray. You find the same three people, they don't come to prayer meetings. So you see, I'm empowering you. Listen, it's the truth. We can call a prayer meeting. We'll get a third of the church. Every church is like that. And you know, the day of Pentecost, it was exactly the same. There were many disciples, many believers, but on the day of Pentecost, there was only 120 in the upper room praying. If you call a prayer meeting, you get a handful. Call a prayer line, you get the whole church. Now, I'm empowering you so that when you get three, you say, let's hold a prayer meeting. Hold a prayer meeting right there where you are. Come on, somebody. If revival is going to hit the earth, hit the world, it's going to go through us. So wherever you are, hold your prayer meeting there. Some of you will be very surprised how the Spirit of God will move. All of a sudden, you set that person free. All of a sudden, everybody wants to serve this Jesus. Because you have a prayer meeting. You see, that's an opportunity for you to hold a prayer meeting. Amen. Point number five, to be constantly connected to divine help, we must maintain our divine connection to the throne of grace. You have to maintain that connection. The job of a pastor or spiritual leader, the job of the fivefold ministry is to get you connected. But once you're connected, you've got to maintain that connection. Come and talk to me. Amen. Hallelujah. So I pray that the fire upon our altar of prayer will be renewed. Amen. That fire on the altar of prayer and praise, that will be renewed. And as we do so, I believe that we will have continued access to God's help in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, let us stand. Thank you, Jesus. I trust you got something today. You are divinely assisted, divinely helped. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Let us pray. Pray with you. Thank you, Jesus. Let us pray together. Heavenly Father, I need your continued help in my life. It is so obvious, O Lord, that without you, I can never make it in this life. Please help me. I need you, O God, every hour. As I come to your throne of grace today, I know that I shall obtain help for the race that I face. And by faith, I receive it now. Amen. 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 another helper, Holy Spirit, to help us, to lead us, to guide us, to give us counsel, to give us direction. I pray for every person, oh God, that your hand shall be upon them, upon their families, upon their homes. Oh God, that you will be with them, protect them, prosper them. Be with our own folk, oh God. Renew their youth as the eagles, O God, we pray. Be with our young children, O God, our young people, our youth. Father God, they carry the blueprints of tomorrow. We pray that your hand shall be upon them, to protect them, O Lord, and keep them far from the enemy. Thank you, Lord, for dreams that will come to pass. Thank you for goals that will be attained by the grace of God. We pray that wherever your people go, that they will be preserved by you, O God. Divine preservation is their portion. Their workplaces and their businesses, their centers of learning and education, study, O God. I pray that they will be prosperous. I pray that they will be fruitful, O God, unto every good work. To you, O Lord God, we give all the praise, the glory, the honor, and the worship. Be the blood of Jesus Christ, your Son, upon every home, O God. Divine protection rest upon them. In Jesus' blessed name. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, of Nazareth, the love of God, sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, rest and abide in each and every one of you, both now and forevermore.